better to talk about the upcoming Memorial Cup than a guy who's actually hoisted the trophy, Ray Ferraro. Does that conjure up some memories there for you?
Yeah, you bet it does. What an awesome time in your career. It's the most important games that you've played in your life, really, until that time. And now for most of these players, it'll be the biggest games they ever play. But there's also NHL scouts here. There's draft rankings on the line. This is a fantastic tournament to play in.
1983 has been a few years. You still remember the moment, though?
I do, because as it turned out, that's the only tournament we ever won, the only one I was ever on the winning side of.
Well, let's look at this year's edition, because one of the players that a lot of people... We are getting closer to puck drop for this Memorial Cup in Game 1 here. We bring Ray Ferraro back into the fold, and boy, the scout cam should be on full display tonight, won't they?
Yeah, there'll be a bunch of people wearing black jackets. That's what the scouts wear, and they'll be sitting up in the corners of the rink watching these players really closely. Now, they've got a book pretty much on every player by this point in the season, but these are critical games to watch, how they'll play against the very best competition. This absolutely will help determine where a player will go in the draft.
Oh, I'm sure. They're playing in those bright lights, and how do you respond? And, you know, one of the other players that a lot of people have been talking about... Oh, it's a gorgeous night. Fans are amped up. I am too. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro, ready for all the action. Both teams lined up in the middle. We are ready to get things underway. Well, the hype for this one has been off the hook. Puck is dropped. Let's see if this one actually lives up to it. O'Rourke's got it in the defensive end. Right up the gut, here they go. Shot denies him with the pad. The Oil Kings scoop it up along the boards. With the steal. With the stop.
Kosa's skill on display there. Good save into the corner with it. Stopped by the goaltender.
There's the whistle as things will slow down here for a moment.
Always a good play if you're not sure what's going on. Freeze the puck.
Lots of time left in this period. The game is still scoreless. Back underway, and they take possession here inside the offensive zone. Good reach of the stick to knock the puck away. Wide of the net.
You don't get the puck dead center very often. He's got to capitalize.
You wonder if that'll come back to haunt them. And they won't connect on that one. Standing by, our own Carlin Bays with all the latest.
Thanks so much, James. You know, the rookie is playing in his very first Memorial Cup, and the hype around social media is real. They're calling him a game changer for whatever team gets him.
Yeah, a lot of buzz about him as play continues here. Puck set across the blue line. Fires it, and he says no! Edmonton's at the back end. Carvalho's dragging it along the line. Taken by Carty. The Oil Kings gain control of the puck against the wall. Looking to make something happen along the boards. Edmonton's playing it from the side. Swatted away with the stick in the defensive zone. That goes wide. Takes the pass. And now he tries to get it across to Mafera. Sault Ste. Marie's got the puck against the half wall and puts it anywhere but the way he wanted it to go. Quick pass to Trott. Big time stop there. Edmonton's got possession of the puck. Taken along the wall by Kubasek. Puck scooped up by Williams. Edmonton's playing it through the neutral zone. And he slides it quickly to Carvalho. And that one's broken up. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Johnston. Sault Ste. Marie's on the attack. From point blank. Picked up along the boards by Dickinson. Here he is, shot right in front. He was locked in there. Quick feed to Oliver. They go on the attack from the left side. Here he is in front. Birkin's going to cover it up and get a whistle.
Even with the traffic starting to close in, he had to grab that when he did.
Still a lot of time left in the period as we approach the midway mark. We've still got zeros on the board. Carroll's won it in their own end. Sault Ste. Marie's got it along the wall. Here's a shot. Stopped by the goaltender. Casas on top of the puck, and that'll stop the play.
Pretty conservative play here, James, as he covers it up to kill the play.
Face-off looming as both centers get into position. The Greyhounds will go to work here in the offensive zone. Makes it look easy with the stop. And now he moves it to Neighbors. And it's a quick pass to Oliver. Pass back to the point. Moves it quickly over to Oliver. The Greyhounds gain possession in their own end. Now he takes it over the line. Kind of lost control for a second there, but regains possession. Made the stop on the play. Oh, there's one more!
Yeah, pretty good positioning here, James. He makes the two stops back-to-back.
Look out! Here they come on the attack! Stops him with a glove! And the goaltender grabs that one for a whistle to try to slow things down here. Sault Ste. Marie's got it in their own zone. Streaking through center, they go on the attack. Hammers a shot off the glove. Quick feed to Carvalho. And now he moves it quickly to Neighbors. And that goes off a player. Edmonton's got control of it now here in the offensive end. The Greyhounds are on the attack. Shot. Oh, serves up waffles for dinner with that stop. Stuffs them again.
Certain saves are more difficult than others. This one right from the slot is turned aside.
Let's go back between the benches. Ray Ferraro standing by. Razor?
Yeah, the coach is up and down the bench here, James. I'm not so sure he's thrilled with the way that their team has played. They've been sluggish, a half a step behind most of the night. And he wants the rookie to promote a little more energy, get more grit into their game.
Inching closer to the midway mark of this period. Still no score in this one. That's kicked away with the pad by Kosa. Tries to get the puck to Oliver. Here's an offensive chance. And now he angles it across to Robertson. Laying out on the play. Beautiful defensive effort. Sault Ste. Marie's ready to go on the attack. The Oil Kings gain control of the puck. Now he slides it up to Carvalho. The Greyhounds take possession in the defensive end. Right up the gut into the attacking zone. And that's stopped by Kosa. And as he opts to freeze the puck, we get a whistle.
Starting to look like a little bit of a fire drill in the zone, so this is a good play.
Centers get set as they're ready to drop the puck again. Good battle along the boards for the puck. The Oil Kings gain possession. Nothing!
Hit the net. No chance to score if you don't get the puck on target.
Here's a shot. Blocked aside. The Oil Kings have it now. They've got some momentum here. And he easily stops that one. Mafara's moving the puck through his own zone. Moves into the slot. Can't get it to go. Grabbed along the boards by Mafara. Edmonton's looking to break out. Moves it to Neighbors. Here they come on the attack. And a great save.
There's always a next level to making a save. Step two is get the puck out of danger. He does a nice job there.
Right in the slot. Oh, stick save and a beaut.
Excellent chance. They work the puck into position, and it's a scoring chance that's turned away.
There's another for the hit parade. Puck battle along the boards. Passes it to Daheniak. Nice zone entry on the left side. Centering pass, and that's broken up. The Greyhounds will play it through the neutral zone. Edmonton's got the puck in their own end. Here we go, one-man rush. Hard hit on the play.
Wow, did he ever finish him hard. And when he dropped, he also dropped his stick. Now he's got to collect himself. Looks like a yard sale out there.
And he handles a cross-ice pass. Snaps one from the slot. He scores! What a goal!
I love this, James. I mean, this is kind of what I did. You get into close quarters here, that puck's got to go quick into the net.
Edmonton's on the board. They lead it 1-0.
I can't believe this game's going to end 1-0. So that first goal gives you a head start into what I hope is a pretty offensive game.
Feeds the puck up to Neighbors. To his teammate. Can't get it to click. And that's deflecting. Scooped up along the wall by Pitlick. Gets it over to Cairns. Puck grab by Pitlick. Receives the pass. And that's turned aside. The Oil Kings take it along the wing. Here's a short pass to Neighbors. Edmonton's got the puck against the wall. Sault Ste. Marie's got the puck. Errant pass and they can't connect. Gets the full use of his stick on the poke check. Loose puck battle along the boards. The Oil Kings have it against the wall. Shot right in front. That's gloved by Birkin.
Great tracking. He finds the puck. He gets the glove up. Makes the save on a dangerous chance.
Here in the late goings of the period, Edmonton's up 1-0. The Greyhounds take it along the wall. Here's a shot. Shuts him down. Edmonton's got a hold of the puck. Sends it ahead to Neighbors. And now it's over to Oliver. From center, they get into the attacking area. Pass right in front. Nothing doing.
Most dangerous place on the ice, and he can't capitalize.
Across the point. Denies him with a save. And the goalie covers up for the whistle. Teams are ready for the draw. The linesman about to drop the puck. Well, that's one way to win the draw as he skates away with the puck after the two centers were tied up. Tries to get it to Neighbors. Great pass from the left wing up the middle now. And that pass attempt is deflected. Denies it in front. There's the whistle as the puck is frozen up. Marie's got a hold of the puck. The Greyhounds will play it in their own end. Gains the zone through the middle. Wrist one in front. Oh, what a stick save.
Yeah, I hated when I missed chances like this, James. You don't get many that are this quality. You want to put them away because you don't know when the next one's going to come.
And momentum on their side as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. And nearing the final 60 seconds of this opening stanza. And there's the save. Scrum along the boards. And that one's broken up. And now he tries to get it across to Oliver. The Greyhounds get a hold of it. Things starting to get a little physical out there. We got a whistle as the puck's frozen. Here in the later stages of this period, Edmonton's ahead 1-0. There's the horn, ending the first period. Both teams will have a chance to regroup. You do you, and we'll be back with period number two in a moment. Face-off here in this second period is about set to go. Handles the puck. And he slides it quickly to Pitlick. Takes the feed. Misses.
Get it on the cage. Make the goalie do something with it.
Edmonton's got it across the line. And he regains control of the puck. And that's a great read to force the turnover.
Sault Ste. Marie's read the play just perfectly tonight. It's like they have the book of the way the game is going to be played. Every time there's a moment of space that's available, they seem to shut it off.
And tries to make a diagonal pass to Mackey. Takes a hit on the play. Edmonton's got a hold of the puck now. Puck picked up by Pitlick. Picked up along the wall by Cairns. From point-blank range, stones him in front. Ties him up, and it didn't go unnoticed in the eyes of the officials here. Takes it into the slot, and that one's blocked.
Yeah, good positioning, James. He gets up tight to the shooter and snuffs that one.
Sault Ste. Marie sending their power play unit out for the first time tonight.
This power play almost jumped off the bench as soon as the penalty was called. They want out. They think they're the answer for the one-goal deficit.
Shoots it over the net. Edmonton's got the puck along the boards. Directs it on over to Carvalho. Quick pass to Oliver. Sends a pass over. He scores! I believe a calling card likes to call those back-to-back.
Yeah, the coaches want you to stay aggressive after you score. They do that, and they're able to put another one up on the board. That shot eludes the goaltender up on the blocker side. They don't like getting beat up there, James. It's one they think they should be able to get a blocker or an arm, something on it.
Lots of hockey left to be played in this period. Edmonton's been the better team here over the last few minutes, increasing their lead to 2. Battle along the boards. Takes the feed. Sends turns the pass over. Scores! What a counterpunch!
Wow, that didn't take very long. After giving up a goal, they get right back onto the attack.
Sault Ste. Marie's back to center ice, and now it is just a deficit of one.
What a difference just the one goal makes in the way that you look at the game, what makes you think is possible. They only need one more to even this up.
Edmonton's got it in their own zone. From the right wing, he moves it to the middle. Move to the middle, and he can't find his man. Fires one on goal. Oh, he got a piece of it to keep it out. And that's broken up. Grabs the puck here inside the offensive end. Right up front. Oh, and I'm sure they'd like to read you on that.
Now, lots of work and nothing for it as they don't get the puck on goal.
The Greyhounds get a hold of the puck along the boards. Over the line they come. And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. Turned aside with the glove by Kosa. And there's the whistle as he elects to slow things down a little.
A pretty good decision here with the play starting to break down in front of him.
Plenty of playing time left in this frame. The Greyhounds still trail by a goal here, but they are back into this one, only down by one. Hope everyone's enjoying the game here tonight. Another big face-off here on this power play. You'll need more than that to beat him. Taken along the wall by Dickinson. And he comes up big with the stick save, getting all of it with the paddle. They score! And we're all tied up! What a little power in the power play!
Not often you get an opportunity and your power play clicks looking so effective as this one just did. They talked about getting traffic to the net. They talked about building secondary options. They were doing that this morning at practice. It came to game time, and they cash in. This game is tied.
And they'll be forced to regroup as the puck escapes the offensive end. Picked up along the boards by Le Carrier. And now he moves it to Johnston. The Greyhounds take it across the blue line. Snaps it onto the net. Oh, a clutch save! Moves across the point. No one home on that play. The Oil Kings gain possession along the wall. Through center. From the point, they take control of it. Puts it into the back of the net for the goal!
That breaks this tie, James. You know when these teams get locked up tight, sometimes it stays that way a long time. He made a big move here on this shot, but there's so much traffic, James. I think he's better off just trying to drop into the butterfly and spread out as best as he can.
The Greyhounds win it. Edmonton's got possession at center. Oh, what a stop with the paddle!
Perkins able to angle that save over to the corner so there's no rebound.
That pass doesn't go. Takes control of the puck. Here's a shot. Oh, and somehow he gets a sliver of it and keeps him at bay. Still lots of time left here in this frame. Edmonton's got the momentum with a one-goal lead. They'd love to add to that. Nice start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone. Grabbed along the boards by Kubasek. The Oil Kings have the puck in the corner. Forces the turnover in the defensive zone. Quick shot! And the lane's clogged up blocking that. Scooped up along the wall by Neighbors. Through the middle of the ice, they enter the attacking zone. That's off a stick. Pinned up along the boards. And some good footwork to kick it away. Nice pass. Pitlick's got it across the line. Moves it quickly over to Mackey. Turns it away. Kosa's going to hang on to that one for a whistle.
Quickly on top of that, James. He needed a cover there.
Some last-second communication with the D as centers get ready to drop the puck. Moves the puck. Now a quick pass to Pitlick. Edmonton's got the puck along the wall. The Oil Kings move it ahead. And he slides it quickly to Cap. Broken up with a stick in the defensive zone.
On the breakaway! Denied!
I don't know what more could be done there. That's a good shot, but the goalie makes a great stop.
Edmonton's got it in the offensive zone. That's gloved by Birkin. Goaltender covers up. We got a stoppage in play. Here in the back half of this period, Edmonton's been the better club as they hold a 4-2 lead at this point. Play is back underway. Quick shot on goal. Sault Ste. Marie's got possession of the puck. Dishes it to Mackey. Moves the puck into the attacking area. Wrist shot from the slot. Well, he's calling him out now.
Laguerriere's ready to go. Apparently, the other guy doesn't want anything to do with him. The ref wasn't having any more of this. It just had enough, and both of them will head to the penalty box.
The Greyhounds win the draw, and he gets in the lane to block that. Edmonton's in now. Puts the puck on net. Stones him with the blocker. And now it's grabbed by Pitlick. Cairns takes the puck. Couldn't complete the pass. Scoops up the puck now. Feeds it on over to Kubacek. And they turn it over in the neutral zone.
Sault Ste. Marie's put themselves in a good defensive posture all night. That's hard work. That's being on top of your game. They've been an excellent team tonight.
The Greyhounds take possession in the defensive end. Comes up with a stop. I think it's a chance for a breather here as he hangs on and covers the puck up.
Who, for the players or for you?
Well, you know, I won't complain. Officials getting ready to drop the puck. Puck possession so key in today's game. Tries to feed it over to Cairns. Into the offensive end now. And that pass can't connect. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Edmonton's on the attack. Cuts to the front. That goes off a twig. Scrum along the boards. They battle for the puck. Favreau's taking it from his own end. Along the right wing, they enter the attacking area. A chance from the slot. Oh, what a save in front.
Kosa's made an excellent stop there in position to keep the puck out.
Neighbors explores his options in the corner. Great heads up play with the stick by O'Rourke. And they can't connect. Mackey's got it on the offensive end. Quick feed to Pitlick. The Greyhounds will play it from the corner. Here's a chance. Fantastic save.
He's going to feel he missed one there. You don't get many chances that clean. The goalie turns it aside.
And the puck stopper hangs on to get a breather here for the team. Past the midway mark of the frame, the Oil Kings have some breathing room as they lead by a pair. It's 4-2. Here in the late going of the frame, it's 4-2. Sault Ste. Marie's got it in the offensive zone. Takes a shot. Off target.
So frustrating. You do all this work, you get it into a good spot, you don't get it on the net.
Grabs the puck here in the neutral zone. The Oil Kings gain control of the puck. From the defensive zone, they move the puck around. The Oil Kings take it across the line. Shoots it. Oh, and he somehow got a little piece of it, and it stays out of the net. And both centers glide into the dot as a faceoff set to resume. Sault Ste. Marie's won the faceoff deep in their own end. Slides the puck over. Great defensive effort with the stick. Passes the puck over to Neighbors. And now he angles it across to Mackey. The Oil Kings scoop it up along the boards. grabs the puck at center. From the right side, he goes to the middle of the neutral zone. The Greyhounds take it from the side. Oh, hello! Comes up with the puck with a quick steal. Nice flick of the stick. The Greyhounds look to start the transition game. Here they come inside the neutral zone. Wrist shot from the slot. Too much traffic in the lane. Moves it to Oliver. The Oil Kings move to the offensive zone. Takes a shot, denied by the goaltender. Into the attacking area from the left side. Turned aside with a glove by Kosa. There's the whistle as the puck stopper elects to hang on. In the final moments of this period, the Oil Kings lead it 4-2. Second period nearly in the books here. Nice play shorthanded as they get control of the puck. Edmonton's got him along the wall. Here's a shot, denied by the puck stopper. Slides it on over to Dickinson. Sault Ste. Marie's moving it along the wing. Fires it, and a beautiful stop by the glove.
Kosa's goaltending at one end and the offensive output at the other has made for a good night.
Johnston's at the faceoff dot, ready to win this draw on the man advantage. The Greyhounds take possession off the faceoff. Makes the save with the glove.
That's an important stop for the goalie. Not only does he make the save, but because he catches it, he kills the play.
Gunther's gliding in for the faceoff as this penalty kill will continue. Johnston's won the draw here in the offensive zone. And the puck stopper jumps on top of it to get a stoppage in play. Teams are ready to go, and we're about moments away from puck drop. Sault Ste. Marie's got it, and they're on the attack. Picked up along the wall by Dickinson. Puts it on goal. Great poke check on the reach. Big time stop. Edmonton's gained possession along the boards. And they get the puck out of the defensive end. The Greyhounds have a hold of it in the defensive zone. Sault Ste. Marie's got it against the boards. Into the middle of the neutral zone. Wrist one. That'll bring an end to the second period of play. Let's get a clean sheet of ice and come back with the third period next. All right, here we go. A big third period set to go. Ray Ferraro, James Cebulski bringing you all the action. The Greyhounds power play won't have a lot of time to work with as this period gets underway. Oh, and that's got the crowd buzzing after that stop.
Atkinson's up and ready to join the play.
That's turned away with the pad by Kosa. Lots of time left in this period. It's a two-goal lead here tonight. 4-2 is where we're sitting. Off the draw, and a nice job locking up his opponent. The Greyhounds come up empty-handed on the power play. We're back to even strength here.
But you work so hard for the lead, you don't want to give it back by coughing up a couple of power plays. They get bailed out by their penalty killers. Nice job there.
Sault Ste. Marie's got a hold of it along the wall. Takes the pass. And it's a quick pass to Constantine. Misses wide. Goes right to the crease. Denies him in close. In front of the net, the goaltender covers up for a whistle on the play. And we're moments away from getting back underway here with the puck drop. Back underway, and they take possession here inside the offensive zone. Up along the wall on the right side and into the attacking area. Birkin's going to give everyone a chance to breathe and hang on to the puck. Edmonton's won the draw, and they'll go to work. In front, and a stoppage on the play as the goaltender covers things up. The frozen biscuits dropped, and we are back underway here. Sault Ste. Marie's got the puck in the defensive end. Slides it across to Mackey. The Greyhounds looking against the half wall. Quick shot!
Whoa.
He scores!
You're down by a couple. You want to give yourself the opportunity for a time goal. They've done that with this one here.
The Greyhounds are back at center ice, probably breathing a little easier now, Ray.
They needed to get one, James. If you trail by two for too long, the clock just runs out on you. You run out of time.
Oliver's got it into offensive territory. Sends it in deep. The Greyhounds have it now. Works it across to Robertson. Makes the save. Sault Ste. Marie's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Moves it up through the middle from the right. Kerens looks around. Oh, gets a blocker on it to turn it away. He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. Denied that one.
Sometimes you make a good shot and you just get beaten by the goaltender. I'd say that's one that you put in that category.
They've got numbers. Scores!
You get one, you get hungry for a second one. Even if you're not a goal scorer, you get that early. Now you want to hunt for a second goal.
Makes it a double on the play.
Hey, we get a good look here where the man advantage break is cultivated. Now they've got it clean in. They don't make a mistake, and the goalie has no chance as it's in the net.
Edmonton's won the draw in the neutral zone. Here's a shot. Oh, what a stop. No quarter given here as they battle for the loose puck along the boards. Tucks it in, and they're right back in a Ray.
They were talking on the bench. Don't give in. Don't give in. Now they get one. Now they've got to find one more.
Sault Ste. Marie's third period deficit suddenly doesn't seem so insurmountable now.
You can almost see the difference in the bench and the body language. They know they've got a chance.
Through center along the wing. Move to the middle, and that's picked off in front. Oliver's carrying it ahead. And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. Here's a short pass to Mackey. Kerens, and that goes off the post and out. Here comes the call.
Oh, you can see the frustration right away, James. Shorthanded now, and only a one-goal lead.
The Greyhounds once again send out their power play unit.
Great opportunity to get this game back to level. A power play trailing by one. This is a huge opportunity.
They'll get set to drop the puck as this power play continues. Snatches the puck with the two centermen locked up. Kassa's going to hang on for a whistle here in the third.
Well, there's not much time left here as you get into the final 20 minutes. The game's close. A mistake now would be critical.
Atkinson's recognizing they're still shorthanded here as they get ready for the faceoff. Steps in and takes the puck. Puck cleared from the defensive end. Sault Ste. Marie's got it behind the net. Kerens plays it into the offensive zone. Scores! New game after that power play marker.
At the very least, you don't want your power play to lose momentum. But when you've got a chance like this to even the score, you got to come up big once in a while if you've got the extra player. They do. The power play clicks, and this game is tied.
Kerens wins it in the neutral zone. Receives the pass.
Kerens has the one goal tonight. You know he'd like to find another and break the tie.
More than half the period left to play. The next goal could be a big one as we are tied. The Greyhounds win it. Misses a golden opportunity there. And now he moves it quickly to Le Carrier. Here he is from the slot. Turned aside with the glove. Puck is frozen, and we get a stoppage in play. Center's gliding up to the faceoff dots here. Sault Ste. Marie's won the faceoff. Quick pass to Mackey. Denies him! He got all of it! And they'll cover it up, forcing a stoppage in play. The Greyhounds will go to work here in the offensive zone. Off a stick. Moves it quickly over to Cairns. Takes a couple of knocks and loses control.
Neighbors grabs a new stick from the bench and he's right back into the play.
Here's a chance. Pad save. He's on it tonight. With possession along the wall. Handles the puck. Sault Ste. Marie's got a hold of it against the wall. Tosses it on to Pitlick. And that doesn't exactly go tape to tape. Slides the puck across. Carries it in. Carvalho's going to play it against the half wall. And skilled use of the stick to poke the puck away. Takes the feed. Quick feed to Mackey. Edmonton's got the puck in their own end. Sault Ste. Marie's got a hold of the puck now. They gain the offensive zone from the middle. Sault Ste. Marie's got it now. Halichak stick handling in his own zone. Slides it across to Mackey. Cuts into the paint. Scores!
The deadlock's broken. That's a big goal, and they put him into the lead.
Sault Ste. Marie's offense has given themselves a one-goal lead here in the third. Now do you sit back and protect it?
That's always dangerous. You invite trouble by the puck being in your zone. Try and play it in the offensive 100 feet as much as you can.
Edmonton's got the puck. With some open space at center. And not much on that one. The Greyhounds get a hold of the puck in their own end. Through the open ice, they're picking up steam. Textbook stop by Kosa. We'll get a face-off after the puck stays covered up. Play set to resume with the face-off ready to go. Sault Ste. Marie's won the draw. Moves the puck along the half wall. The Oil Kings gain possession. Carvalho swooping in on the attack. Sends a pass over. Easily turned aside. He scores!
Three goals, the hat trick's in the bag. Here come the hats. What a great feeling as this place is jumping. The rebound snapped away. What a nice shot. But the goalie's got to do a better job cleaning up that rebound. You can't leave it right there.
Edmonton's heart on full display here in the later stages of this third period with that big goal.
Never back down, kept pushing, finally even this game up. Now hopefully can find the winner.
And the puck skips off the glove. Moves it to Cairns. Oh, he stops him with the glove. Great reflexes there. 51 seconds. The Greyhounds win the faceoff. The Oil Kings will play it from the defensive zone. And no luck on that pass attempt. Centering pass! How did he stop that one?
Yeah, he's right in front of the puck too, so there's really nowhere that puck's gonna squeak through.
And just like that comes up with the puck. Great little flick of the stick. They've got the defense outnumbered. And that carries off a stick. Here's a short pass to Dickinson. Takes the feed. Along the half wall with the puck. Oh, they telegraphed the pass and he picks it off. And now it's over to Dickinson. Carries the puck up through center. Sault Ste. Marie's across the blue line. Grabs it with the glove.
Really like his positioning here as he's able to get the glove up there to make the save. But it doesn't have to be a spectacular
crazy save because he's in a good spot.
Teams are lined up and we are ready to take this draw. Halashak's lugging the puck. Quick pass to Dickinson. Can't connect on the pass. Long reach breaks up the momentum. Takes a bump but still hangs on to the puck. Edmonton's looking to break out of their own end. Sends the pass over. Edmonton's got the puck along the wall. Just can't complete that pass.
No, he's got the right play in mind. He just doesn't execute the final pass.
Takes a wrist shot. Denies him! The Oil Kings gain control of the puck against the wall. Tried to connect the pass, but it doesn't go. Takes it across the blue line. Moves it quickly over to Carvalho. Good battle along the boards for the puck. Sault Ste. Marie's got possession of the puck. Driving right to the front. Oh, how did he get a piece of that? Tries to make that cross ice feed. Nice pass. Slides it across. Up the outside of the iron and will play on.
Edmonton's got to feel a little unlucky here. Off the post and the game's still tied.
From the slot. Puck scooped up by Cairns. Some solid defensive work in their own end with the poke check. Kasa's going to opt for the whistle and give everybody a chance to breathe.
Sometimes you get running around as the shift gets long. This helps.
A critical draw here. O'Rourke's got the puck in his own zone. Settles things down and gets control of it once again. Throws it in. Edmonton's got the puck along the wall. The Greyhounds have it in the offensive end. And the puck's kicked free. Edmonton's got control of it now from their own end. Sault Ste. Marie's got the puck along the boards. The Greyhounds go to work on offense. And he makes the save. Moves the puck. And he connects with the long bomb. Slides the puck over. The Oil Kings played along the boards. Here he is in close. Oh, how do you miss?
By trying to be imperfect. I mean, this goaltender is so good. You've got to get that in the perfect spot.
Sault Ste. Marie's on the attack. And he uses his reach to disrupt the play. The Oil Kings have it now. Takes the pass. Moving to the middle. Right in front with the shot. The Greyhounds have it behind the net. Along the side, here they come through the neutral zone. The Oil Kings gain control of the puck. Here they come up along the wing. Fires it into the offensive zone. Angles it over to Dickinson. And now he tries to get it across to Trott. Drives it to the crease, and that's picked off in front. There's the horn bringing regulation time to an end. We got overtime coming up next.
Join us for our next team practice, which will be open to the public. Admission is simply by donation, with all proceeds going to the local charity.
Who'll be the hero? Will there be a zero? Overtime set to go. Slides it diagonally to Oliver. Great positioning by the defender. Puck dumped in. The Oil Kings have it now. Schaffler's got it in the defensive end. Feeds the puck to Neighbors. Quick feed to Carvalho. And makes the routine save. There's the whistle as things will slow down here for a moment.
Always a good play if you're not sure what's going on. Freeze the puck.
Face-off looming as both centers get into position. And as the puck is dropped, they win the draw here inside the defensive zone. Pitlick's got it through center. And couldn't find the intended receiver on that one. The Greyhounds get a hold of the puck along the boards. Moves it over to Cairns. That's not going to fool him. Goaltender covers it up. We get a whistle to slow things down. A big faceoff here inside the offensive end. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Receives the pass. Kind of lost control for a second there, but regains possession. Scoops up the puck here. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Cairns. The Oil Kings gain possession along the wall. Moves it to Carvalho. Sault Ste. Marie's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Takes it to the front. Oh, that's a big time save. I think he got it with a toe. This is a face-off. They'll definitely want to win here inside the offensive zone. Sends it quickly to Neighbors. Couldn't connect on that pass. And we got a delayed penalty coming up here. And there's the whistle stopping the play. Carvalho's getting called for 2 minutes here by the officials. About to drop the puck, and you'd sense that the power play unit's feeling the sense of urgency on this one.
Well, here's an important man advantage, a critical point in the game, and they've been successful. They've had a really good run on the power play tonight.
Good reach to the stick to knock the puck away. Quick pass across to Neighbors. Snaps one here in the slot. Blocked in traffic. The Greyhounds are on the attack. For the win! There it was! He misses the net! And the puck's booted away. Atkinson's picking up steam. Here's an odd man rush. And that's blocked. Here's a short pass to Atkinson. He was locked in there. From the right side, they gain the zone. He grabs the puck here at the point. Drives to the paint. Oh, bold move by the goaltender as he pokes it away. And that one's blocked. Snapper from the slot. Too much congestion in front. Now he takes it over the line. Sault Ste. Marie's got the puck in their own end. Gets the full use of his stick on the poke check. And he slides it quickly to Atkinson. Now a quick pass to Carvalho. Centering pass! Oh, and he'll be shaking his head on that as they were so close. Johnston's moving the puck through his own zone. Quick pass to Trott. Snaps one on net. Oh, and he just gets a piece of it. Great extension on the play. Taken along the wall by Trott. Edmonton's got it in their own zone. Puts it in deep. Here in the corner, he grabs the puck. Takes a shot. Glove save made by Birkin. There's the whistle as the goalie hangs on. A big draw looming here in the offensive zone. Sault Ste. Marie's got the puck. Takes the feed at center and moves up ahead. And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. Quick pass over to O'Rourke. On the attack along the boards. Sault Ste. Marie's got control of it now here in the offensive end. Casas on top of that one for a whistle.
Little bit of traffic starting to form around the net.
A lot on the line here in this offensive zone faceoff. Carroll's won the draw. Takes the feed at the back end. Takes a shot.
Oh, puck doesn't get there. It's so crowded in front of the goaltender.
Stays with it. Makes a move in front. His reflexes on display tonight. And now he moves it to Neighbors. Off the left wing and into center.
Neighbors has been so entertaining to watch tonight. He's got 3 points. He doesn't look like he's going to slow down.
Sault Ste. Marie's got the puck against the boards. Moves it quickly over to Carroll. And makes the save. Edmonton's got a hold of it along the wall. Great reach with the poke check by Neighbors. And now he angles it across to Carvalho. Sault Ste. Marie's gained possession along the boards. The Greyhounds get a hold of the puck in their own end. Here's a shot! Ah, that goes awry.
Man, they create the scoring chance, and it's a good one, but they don't get it on the net.
Through the neutral zone, moving the puck along the side. Moves inside! There it is! There it is! They score to win it in overtime! Edmonton's feeling much better about themselves as they come away with the OT win.
Well, they really pushed after it after nothing settled in regulation. They get the winner here in extra time.
He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. We will see you in the next round of this tournament as it continues on. Good night. Phenomenal performance. And here to talk a little more about what we saw on the ice is Ray Ferraro. And Razor, I mean, what does that do for his draft stock?
Oh, man, it'll put a rocket to it. If he continues to play in this tournament like that, the scouts are going to get more and more interested. Also, a little more jittery, as they might have had a player slotted in a certain area of the draft. He plays like that, he's going to jump a couple of spots in the draft for sure. This is really an important start to the tournament for him.
Yeah, and this is where kind of all of a sudden the stocks kind of rise and fall here, right?